old man sits on the chair in my lounge room. His face has seen years, his eyes have shed tears. He's been through a lifetime, his friends have all gone. He waits in his chair as I walk down the stair. He looks up at me and his face forms a smile. His eyes fill with life as he notices me. His body is ancient, yet he looks so happy. He opens his mouth and greets me with glee. I look at the old man, I smile politely. I shake his leathery hand. He gets to his feet and I look in his eye. I open my mouth and address the old man. How did you get in my house, old man? I don't know who you are. You seem like a very sweet, nice old man, but I don't know who you are. The old man laughs and calls me Tobias. He thinks it's a game when I say my real name. He asks how my wife is and how are my children. I tell him I'm single, he laughs it away. He walks to the kitchen and he puts on the kettle. He asks me if I want some tea. I tell him okay and the water starts boiling. He fills up my cup and hands it to me. I'm sorry, but that isn't milk, old man. I still don't know who you are. You've put mayonnaise in my tea, old man, and I don't know who you are. The old man stops. I think I've upset him. His smile disappears. His eyes fill with tears. He puts down the teacup, looks up at me slowly and says, "Dear Toby, I hate those Japs." I wander upstairs and I fetch him some trousers. He puts them on in the usual way. He tells me that he doesn't know where he's going. I say there's a room and that he can stay. You can live in my house, old man. I don't care who you are. You're pretty racist but funny, old man, and I quite like who you are. Yes, I quite like who you are.